Hello and welcome to this third normalization tutorial for beginners. In this video, we will learn about the third normal form. What is 3nf? A table that is in 3nf is already in 2nf. This means that it is already in 1nf also. Each non-key column depends on the candidate key and nothing else. Recall from the last video that candidate key means one or more columns whose value is unique in every row. Now let us see some examples of tables that are not in 3nf and how to convert them to 3nf. This is a token allocation table. Its columns are token, date, customer name and customer address. Now this table stores data for tokens given out to customers after they visit a place with a queue of people. For example, a bank branch, hospital outpatient department, or any customer care center. The people wait for their turn to be seen. The tokens always start from 1 every morning. For example, on January 9th, token 1 was given to Abe. On the same day, January 9th, token 2 was given to Ben. The candidate key in this table is token and date columns together because this pair is unique in every row. Now a specific token allocated on a particular date is related to exactly one customer. So customer name depends on the candidate key. A specific token on a particular date is related to exactly one customer address. But customer address also depends on customer name, which is not the key. So this table is not in 3nf. This gives rise to issues. For example, Ben's customer address is duplicated because Ben visited on both January 9th and January 10th, 2017. In order to convert token allocation table to 3nf, customer address has to be taken out of it. So token allocation table is broken into two tables. First, we have the customer table with columns customer name and customer address. Customer name is the candidate key of the table. Customer address depends on customer name. The remaining token allocation table has columns token, date, and customer name. Token and date together are the candidate key in this table. Once these tables are in 3nf, customer address for a particular customer, for example Ben, exists in a single place and can be updated there. Now let us see another example. This problem example is the order details table. It has columns order number, product number, quantity and total. This table stores data of each line item of every order. The order information is stored in a separate orders table. The product information including unit price is stored in a separate products table. Now in order details table, one order can have multiple items. Let's say product number 1 has a price of $100 and product number 2 has a price of $50. Now the order number is 2017-1. Has product number 1 with a quantity 1, so the total is $100. The same order number 2017-1 also has product number 2 with a quantity of 1 and the total is $50. So the grand total of this order number 2017-1 is $150. Another order number 2017-2 has only product 1 but the quantity is 2, so the total is $200. The third order 2017-3 has only product number 2, quantity 2. Each product number 2 is $50, so the total is $100. Now the candidate key in order details table is order number and product number together. Quantity depends on both order number and product number because it is for a specific order and specific product number. But the total column is a calculated value. Total is the product of quantity and unit price of product. So total does not depend on the key but something else. Therefore, this table is not in 3NF. To convert order details table to 3NF, we can just drop the total column because it was a result of some calculation only. Now we have seen database normalization explained with examples, how to test if a table is in 3NF or not. We need to check, is each criterion of 1NF and 2NF satisfied? Next, what are the candidate keys in each table? For each candidate key, which columns are not a part of it? Does each such column depend on only the candidate key and nothing else? Now in this normalization 3NF video, we have seen what is 3NF and we saw some examples of tables that were not in 3NF and the normalization techniques to convert them to 3NF. We also saw the tests to check if a table is in 3NF or not. That's all in this video series. Thank you and see you in my other video series.